Roger, Paul Smalley is actually the man in charge of the whole thing. He's the aircraft captain and he's the handling pilot today. Just over 1600 flying hours, and he started as a jump lead. For those of you not familiar with that term, that's to do with the Royal Marine Commando pilots and their squadrons of the Sea Kings, operating with the Commando Helicopter Force based in the Royal Naval Air Station at Yeovilton. Such a place we piloted in 2012 after three tours with the jump in Afghanistan. Back on the ground there, you see the Scott going over the next casualty. Greg ensuring that he is secure, of course, before giving the instruction to lift them up. Greg actually joined the Navy in 2001 as a gunner before transferring to the aircrew role in 2006. Shortly after that, he also trained and qualified as a paramedic. There you see how the two roles are immediately doubled up to give immediate first aid. And he's carried out well over 100 search and rescue call-outs since he's been assigned to this particular job. While immediate first aid work is now carried out in the rear of the cockpit there, of course, the crew will be in touch with the nearest ship or the nearest emergency services to ensure that the casualty is taken to the next appropriate location. Alongside Paul is Lieutenant Phil Ross. He's the youngest of the crew with less than 500 hours, but he joined in 2008, qualified also as a search and rescue pilot just earlier this year, and also lives and flies down in Cornwall. Now, in between the winchman and the crew is, of course, the all-important observer, winch operator, very much the key to the whole thing, and we've got a very experienced man in the guise of Lieutenant Commander Paul Robertson there in the centre. You may well catch sight of him occasionally as they're flying past. He's been in the Navy since 1986 and has got well over 4,000 hours and over 170 search and rescue call-outs to his name. He trained, first of all, as an anti-submarine observer before then qualifying as an instructor. He's carried out previous tours on 826, 814 and 819. Also as part of the Navy Flying Standards team before then going on to join 771. Very rare treat for them to be carrying out anyway. many rescues on a nice sunny day. Most of their work done in the dark of winter in heavy rolling seas and low clouds, operating up to 200 miles away from the home base.